Good morning, my dear friends. I am Dr. M. H. Chennaiah, and in today's YouTube video, we are going to learn the procedure followed to design a pair of bevel gears. Friends, you know, the spur gears and helical gears are used to transmit power between parallel shafts, whereas bevel gears are used to transmit power between shafts whose axes intersect. So there are three different types of these bevel gears, namely a right angle bevel gear, in which the angle between the intersecting shafts is 90 degree, and they are also known by the other name, crown gears. So unless otherwise specified, bevel gears is always a right angle bevel gear. And then we have an obtuse angle bevel gear, wherein the axis of the two shafts intersected at an angle of less than 90 degrees. So similarly, we have an obtuse angle bevel gear, wherein the axis intersect at an angle of more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. Friends, in today's session, I am going to take up a problem on bevel gear when the diameters of the gears are known. That is, I know both the diameter of the pinion and that of the gear. And let's see what is the procedure to be followed to design the gears completely. So, as usual, in the first step, I am going to select the material. Friends, here I told you, in all the machine design data handbooks of mechanical engineering subject, you will have list of material which are generally used for the bevel gears. So, and you have the material along with the allowable static stress sigma naught. So, in today's problem, I am going to take same material for both gear and pinion, and the material I am going to select is 0.2% carbon steel heat treated for both gear and pinion. So, I will say select 0.2% carbon steel for both gear and pinion. For both gear and pinion. So, it will have an allowable static stress sigma naught is equal to 193 Newton per mm square. So, this is same for both. I can say sigma naught of pinion, which is also equal to sigma naught of gear. Means both the materials selected have the same value of this sigma naught. Friends, the next step we take is step number 2, wherein I am going to evaluate or to determine what is the weaker member, or which one of these two is the weaker member. So step 2 is to decide the weaker member of gear pair. That means among the pinion and the gear, we have to find out or determine which is the weaker member. Friends, I told you in the previous session, generally in any of these gears, whenever they are made of the same material, pinion is the weaker member and the design is based on pinion. So, we'll have to make a statement here and say, since pinion and gear are of same material, comma, pinion is the weaker member and the design is to be based on the pinion. So, this is applicable for the spur gear, bevel gear, helical gear, etc. Friends, we have already learnt about the selection of material, then about the decision regarding the weaker member of the gear pair, and in the step number 3, which is a very important step in the design of these gears, we are going to find out what is the module. So, the third step will be to find module which is represented by small m. The units of this are millimeter. Here friends, like our spur and helical gears, we are going to use modified Lewis equation to obtain the module, and for the bevel gears the equation runs like this, that is Ft is equal to sigma naught Cv B y m r minus b by r. These equations you need not by heart, these are all available in the machine design data handbook. So let's see what these terms stand for. Friends, this Ft is the tangential load on the gear tooth, or this is given by the torque divided by the radius multiplied by a service factor Cs. And friends, to find out Mt, we need to have the power to be transmitted and also at what speed it is transmitted. So I'll write down here, Mt is equal to 9550 into capital N by small n multiplied by 10 to the power of 3 Newton millimeter is the equation this used to get the value of Mt. Friends, here this N stands for the power to be transmitted by the drive, and this small n stands for the speed of the gear or pinion. Here this N refers to the speed of the member which is weaker. So obviously I should take this here N1, the speed of the weaker member, that will be given in the question along with this N, the power to be transmitted. So you will be able to get what is Mt. Friends, coming to this R, R is the radius of the weaker member. Here pinion is weaker, and hence we are going to take this as D1 by 2. Say this D1 is given as some 80 mm. So this will be 80 by 2, that is 40 millimeter. And the value of the service factor generally varies from 1.5 to 2. So we are assuming this to be 1.5, we will be able to find out what is Ft. So I know Mt, I know the radius, I know the service factor, I will be able to find out what is Ft. Friends, on the same lines, let us see what are these. Next comes the term sigma naught. The sigma naught is the allowable static stress for the weaker member. So here you know the value of sigma naught is 192.3, I think I have taken already, 193 Newton per mm square for the material 0.2% carbon free heat treated. And then you know this value. Next comes Cv. What is Cv? Cv in some data handbook is also represented by Kv. Both mean the same, it is only a notation. So Cv stands for the velocity factor. Friends, there is a term velocity in that. So when you know the velocity, you will be able to find out this Cv depending on the range of velocity, and this velocity is given by the formula. Velocity Vm is equal to pi d1 n1 by 60, which is also equal to pi d2 n2 by 60. Friends, here this d1 n1 is equal to d2 n2. Whether you calculate this for the pinion or the gear, it will be same. And in this problem, since pinion is weaker, I am going to use this equation, pi by 60 multiplied by the diameter, 80 mm I have taken. So I am going to convert that to meter multiplied by diameter, okay. This is meter, then this N1 is the speed, say 1200 rpm, that will be specified in the problem. So you will be able to get a value, say some 12.6, say, because I am not calculating any of these values and you are just learning the procedure followed, and the unit of this will be meter per second. So friends, we have got this value. So Cv we have got. Then comes B. B is the face width of the gear. The face width of the gear is generally varies from 6 module, the B face width, it varies from 6 module to 10 times module, M is module. So generally I take this as 8 times module, an average value. So I am going to keep this in terms of module, which is not known. The term capital Y is pi into small y. So where small y is the Lewis form factor, so I can say here pi into y of pinion, because pinion is the weaker member. So friends, here whenever the diameters are known, you have to find out the number of teeth, and hence I am going to keep this y in terms of pi into y only. And then friends, you have got one m here. What is this r and b? Friends, r is called the cone distance. R is called the cone distance, and generally this value of r will vary from 1/3 b, or can say r is equal to 3 times b, 3 times the face width. So friends, with this substitution here, this r minus b by r gets reduced to 3b minus b divided by 3b, that is 2b divided by 3b, and this is 2 by 3, this is 2 by 3. So friends, let us make this substitution and see what form this equation takes finally. So ft, we know the value, we have calculated. Sigma naught is known, Cb have calculated from the formula, and this b is equal to 8 times module we have assumed, y is equal to pi into y, small y, and then this is m, m is m, r minus b by r is 2 by 3 in the simplified form. So friends, finally you got 1 m here, 1 m here, and you got this value of y here. So this works out in the form m square y equal to some quantity, a known definite value. Simply I will take this as some 2.65, say I have not calculated, assuming this to be 2.65, and here the diameters are known, and this value is going to be a permissible value or an allowable value. So m square y is equal to 2.65. Friends, now after getting this, you will have to find out for what combination of m and y you will get a product equal to 2.65. So I am going to have some trials made using standard values of module from the data handbook and arrive at the required module. So friends, if you refer to the data handbook, you will have more than 20 different materials used for this gears, and the corresponding values of sigma naught is available there. So now friends, similarly for this module, we have values varying from 0.05 millimeter till 100 mm. So what I do in the trial number 1 to find out m, trial 1, I am going to take m is equal to 5 mm. Now friends, this diameter d1 is equal to mz1, the formula, since pinion is weaker, I have taken like this. If gear were weaker, I would have taken d2 is equal to mz2. D1 is 80 given in the question, module I have assumed as 5, and this z1 is z1. So z1 is equal to 16 teeth. So there will be 16 teeth on the pinion. Now basically I want to compare this m square y permissible which is equal to 2.65 with the induced value. So all this I am writing to obtain the value of y, because y is based on z. Friends, remember for the bevel gears, this Lewis form factor is based on the virtual number of teeth or formative number of teeth. So I will write down y for the pinion, assuming 14.5 degrees involute profile. The formula is y 0.124 minus 0.684 divided by z, and this z is zv. Zv is virtual number of teeth or formative number of teeth. Then how to find out this virtual number of teeth? Friends, in the design data handbook for this bevel gears, we have the relation, the transmission ratio I. I is transmission ratio, is given by tan delta 2, which is equal to 1 by tan delta 1. This is the equation given for this delta 1 and delta 2, where this delta 1 and delta 2 are semi-cone angles of pinion and gear, one for the pinion and two for the gear, pinion and gear. So now we have to find out. So friends, how to obtain this transmission ratio? In any of the problems and gears, they will give you two speeds or two diameters or number of teeth and pinion and gear. So you should be able to get the value. For example, say in this problem, they have given the value of transmission ratio as 2.9, say 2.9. So I will just get the value of these delta 1 and delta 2. So I will say here, this ZV or Z1V for the pinion is equal to Z1 by cos delta 1, where delta 1 and delta 2, I told you they are the semi-cone angles. So here, if I take this as 2.9 is equal to 1 by tan delta 1. So you will be able to get the value of delta 1. It approximately works out to around 19 degrees. It is an angle. So once you know delta 1, delta 2 will be 90 minus 19, that is 71 degrees. Because in this right angle bevel gear, delta 1 plus delta 2 is the total cone angle, semi-cone angle, is equal to sigma, a representation that is equal to 90 degrees. For acute angle bevel gears, this will be lesser than 90. For obtuse angle bevel gears, it will be more than 90, but lesser than this thing. So friends, I have got the value. I have this delta 1 as 19 degree. So if I substitute here, Z1V is 16 number of teeth given, or we just assume, divided by the cos delta 1 value. Cos delta 1 is cos of 19 degree. Say you will get around 20 teeth, say. This is the virtual number of teeth or formative number of teeth which you are going to use in this formula Y to obtain the Lewis form factor. So with this, friends, I will be able to get the ZV, Z1V. I have substituted here, I can get the value of Y. So with all these, let us see the comparison we are going to have. So friends, M square Y permissible value have got, M square Y induced is equal to 5 millimeter module you have taken, and the Y have got is a 0.1205. Say, because I am not going to calculate this, say this works out to 2.75, say again, because I am not calculating any of these values, only the procedure I am telling you. Friends, if you compare this permissible value with the induced value, you observe that the induced value is 2.75, whereas the permissible value is 2.65. That is to say, the induced value is higher than the permissible value, and hence the design is not safe. So what is to be done? Now we have to make some more trials, say trial number 2, 3, etc. by taking standard values of module from the table. Say this has become, this is only 2.65, this is 2.75. To reduce this induced value, you can try with a smaller value of module, such as M is equal to 4 in the second trial, trial number 2. So we are going to repeat the procedure and say in the second case, you are going to get this value 2.49. Say that is by taking the value of this as 4 and the value, you are going to get 2. Now we can conclude the induced value is 2.49, whereas the permissible value is 2.65, and hence the design is safe and you can go ahead with this value of module. So I am going to write down the value of module and use that value of module as 4 mm for all the further calculations. It is a standard value from the table. So friends, once you have this module, you can also find out what is the value of B, the face width, that is 8 times module. So 8 into 4, that is 32 millimeter, and so on. So calculation of this module is a very important step in the question on this, any of these gears. Friends, you are able to get the module for this bevel gear. Next friends, we have the step number 4, in which we are going to check for wear and dynamic load. We are going to check for wear and dynamic load. So in the equations on bevel gears, there is a formula. He says wear load Fw should be greater than Fd, the dynamic load. So we have to find out these two items separately and arrive at the value. So you can ask me, so what is the need to find out or to check for this wear and dynamic load? Friends, by calculating these two loads and equating them, you will be able to get a constant by name the load stress factor, from which you can arrive at the hardness of gear and pinion to which they are to be heat treated. So friends, we have this Fw given by D1 BQK by cos delta 1. This equation is given in the data handbook. Now, what are these values, friends? Friends, we know what is D1, diameter of the pinion, that is given in this question. B is equal to 8 times module, that is 8 into 4, that is 32 mm. And we have this Q is called ratio factor, and that is given by 2Z2V divided by Z2V plus Z1V. The Q is based on the formative number of teeth. Friends, you know what is Z1V? On the same range you can get Z2V from the formula. Z2V is Z2 divided by cos delta 2. You know delta 2 value, you can get this value. And after substitution, say you are going to get this equal to 1.55. I will say because we are not calculating the value. This delta 1 value is known to us. D1 is known, B is known, Q is known, only K is to be found out. That is to say, at the end of this calculation, we are going to get this Fw in terms of K, and this K is called the load stress factor, which is to be obtained by equating this and Fd. Friends, let us go to the second parameter, that is the dynamic load. The dynamic load Fd is given by Ft plus 21B, VRVM, both are same, Ft plus BC divided by 21VM plus square root of, you can say 21VM, Ft plus square root of Ft plus VC. Friends, here this V is VM, we know Ft already. We have calculated in the third step. Vm we know for the pinion, Ft we know, B is the face width. This B you should remember, it is 8 times module, and this module 8 times 4, that is 32 mm. But in this formula, it should be kept in terms of meter, 32 by 1000, that is millimeter, I am converting to meter, so many meter, because the value of C obtained, another constant C, from this equation, from the table based on the material, it is going to be in terms of Newton per meter, and hence the product should give you Newton. So B should be in meter, this should be in kg, so Newton per meter, the product will come out in the form of Newton. So friends, you know all these values, substitute the values and get what is the value of FD. So now we are going to have this FW is equal to D1BQK. We got it in terms of K, that is equal to FD. We know the value, we have calculated. So this value is known, only K is unknown. This is to be greater. So we can get K should be greater than some quantity, maybe 1.223, say. You are going to get the value of K, a number, by equating this FW and FD. Friends, after getting this value of K, there is a table in the machine design data handbook in this form, that is, you have the Brinell hardness number for the gear and pinion, for the pinion and also for the gear. The value of K, load stress factor, is given for both 14.5 degrees profile and 20 degrees profile. So if you are working out the problem using 20 degrees profile, you have to see under this column. I have taken 14.5 degrees profile, so I am going to see the value of K here. So say the value of K is somewhere here, whatever the value you have got, 1.2 something, whatever you have got there. Then once you know the value of K, then after getting that value of K, just see towards left of this BHN column. So here you will be getting the value of BHN, maybe 550. So based on K, you are getting the hardness number of pinion and gear. So this will give you clearly to what hardness the gear and pinion are to be hardened to withstand this wear and dynamic load. Friends, I hope all of you have followed the procedure that is commonly used to design a pair of 90 degree bevel gears. And friends, if you find this is of help to you, the student community, you please inform all your friends, let them also learn this machine design. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel, Mechanical Engineering Lecture Series by Dr. Annaya. And by subscribing, you will be motivating me, and I will be able to do more and more such number of videos to the student community in different subjects like machine design, engineering drawing, engineering mechanics, etc. I thank you all for the listening of my YouTube video, and I wish you all a good day. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. And this is Dr. M.H. Annaya signing off.